Hello guys, we are here expand your consciousness, giving you the best life advice and exposing the matrix. In this video, we're gonna talk about how to heal ourselves. How to heal yourself, you know. First of all, we have to realize that we become what we tap into. Okay. We have to ask ourselves, are you focusing on what you want or are you focusing on what you fear? Because everything is mental. We create our reality based in our thoughts and feelings. And once you change your thoughts, you change how you interact with your reality. Okay, once you change the perception about yourself, you begin, that has the power to change the genetic structure of your DNA. And this is key to healing, okay? The perception of ourselves is more important of the perception other people have for us. It's all about how we see ourselves. You know, for example, you have people with anorexia, you know. And if they see themselves fat in the mirror, if they see themselves as a fat person in the mirror, it doesn't matter what you tell them. It's actually what they see. So when we see that belief, when we see that belief is the program that creates the reality, we begin to develop more health and wellness. You see, the Holy Trinity. Okay, you see the Holy Trinity. Thoughts, words, and actions create our reality. And all of this is coming from the belief system we got. It's all mind. You know, your belief systems are based in the programming of your subconscious mind, okay? And the subconscious mind is programmable. So a fifth dimension consciousness perspective is, if I wanna change something, for example, if I wanna heal, I have to change my belief system. Okay, you can try to force things out there, but you will struggle forever if you force things out there. That's the 3D perspective. I'm trying to force the change out there, and yeah, I'm struggling forever. And that won't really help you to heal, you know. You need to change your belief system. If you're gonna heal, you need to begin to eat healthy foods. No, we need to learn our bodies to know our avatar, you know. You see, our mind is the first home, the body is the second, and the earth is the third. We need to take proper care of all three of them. So we need to be mindful of what we are eating. If we want to heal ourselves, you know, we need to eat foods that are full of nutrients. Foods that give life to you. What worked for me was to move as close as possible to a vegan diet. Okay, that gave me more energy, more clarity, you know, less brain fog. I gain a lot, but. Yeah, my body is weird. You need to learn your body. Every human body is different. You have to adjust the foods in the needs of your body, okay? You know, your body always gives signals and responds differently to different foods. You need to be aware of that. You need to be aware of those signals. You know, your body always giving you signals out there. That's what you have to do if you want to heal. If you want to heal, you have to get in touch with nature. Okay, nature have healing abilities. Also help you to raise your frequency. Also earthing helps, you know, walking on ground, barefoot. You see, the modern medicine only heals the symptoms, okay? Only heals the symptoms, only cures the symptoms. But the modern medicine doesn't cure the root cause of the problems, okay? And you have to realize that nature is so smart that put medicine inside the foods, okay? So you need to fix your diet and use the modern medicines, you know, as a supplement to heal the root cause. It all begins in your plate. You have to realize that you become what you consume with all your senses. Okay, so you have to be really, really mindful of what you are listening to. Okay, are you listening music that is gonna uplift you? Are you listening music that is food for your soul? Are you feeding your subconscious mind with positive imagery? Are you breathing clean, fresh air? Or are you always in a big city in an environment full of cars? All this stuff combined will help you heal, okay? Also, our body has a mechanism to act out emotions. You see, the whole matrix programming taught us that acting out emotions is inappropriate, okay? Crying, screaming, shaking, you know, loud laughing, singing in public. It's not acceptable by this society. But acting out emotions is a natural reflex you have for a reason. You have to be thankful for that. You have to be, I mean, grateful for that, that you have the ability to act out the emotions. So if we keep all these toxic energies inside our system, our emotional body is getting overloaded up, you know, to a point. You get overloaded to a point that can lead to serious depression, that can lead to serious illnesses if you don't act out your emotions. So all this dense negative energy is getting stuck inside you, and then it materializes inside your body. Okay, it's all connected. It's all energy. It later turns out to serious illnesses such as cancer, you know, heart attacks, whatever. It can turn out to body illnesses. So instead of blaming ourselves for the ability to act out the emotions, when we feel like crying, you know, like crying, screaming, all this stuff, we need to be thankful for for us having the possibility to release that. Okay, that's how you heal yourself. You need to act out your emotions. You need to get all this dense negative energy outside your body. Okay, your human body have this mechanism. You heal yourself by loving yourself. You heal yourself by learning yourself. You have to love yourself. Okay, you have to be kinder on yourself. You know, healing is a step-by-step process, okay? You have to accept yourself. You have to accept and love yourself unconditionally. Healing takes time. Healing takes time. You see, first of all, you have to spot the root cause of the problem, okay? You have to spot the root cause of the problem. If it's a mental problem, okay, if it's a story in your mind, you have to spot the root cause, the story that created all this stuff inside your mind. You have to climb up, you know, you have to go to to the root of the tree, where it all began. Okay. That's how you heal, that's how you heal yourself. Your heart is your healer. When you spot the root cause and you bring it to conscious, your heart will burn, you know, will purge out every negative attachment connected to that to that story. Also, your human body heals when you move it. Okay, so combining this human body has the ability to heal. The more you move it, the more it heals. Okay, but you need balance there as well. Okay, you need to respect it. You need to see how the body reacts when you move it.
There is a thin line between of what is healthy and what does bad to your human body. Okay, every human body is different. So combining exercising with nature and embracing the sun is one of the best ways to heal your body, you know, to get that vitamin D. It's one of the best ways to heal your body and raise your frequency. You are winning so much for an hour up there. If you combine aerobic exercise, for example, running in nature, or cycling in nature, or, you know, swimming, you win so much. You heal your body. You raise your frequency. If you do it correctly, you heal your body. You raise your frequency. You heal your mind. You gain confidence. You better your mood because of all those endorphins. And in the end, the paradox is that you have more energy after you train. You have more energy for the rest of the day. And you're getting so much for just an hour or an hour and a half of workout. You're getting so much. Okay, so this is the video for today. You know, how to heal yourself. Some info that really helped me to heal myself, you know. If you like the video, you know, say subscribe, you know, share the message, support the channel, and see you in the next video, guys. Peace out.